On March 5th, 1963, the small plane carrying Patsy Cline, manager Randy Hughes, and her fellow country stars Hawkshaw Hawkins and Cowboy Copas crashed in rural Tennessee while en route home to Nashville. There were no survivors. Patsy Cline was dead at age 30. Nashville was stunned into grief and silence. There was talk of canceling the Grand Ole Opry that weekend. Instead, Patsy's vocal backup group, the Jordanaires, bravely sang gospel music in her memory. Instead, Minnie Pearl walked out and told jokes through her tears. Instead, the show went on. Country music had lost one of the greatest voices in its history. But in a sense, Patsy Cline has never died. Neither the public nor the music world has ever forgotten her. And as long as there are listeners to hear her immortal songs, she will continue to hypnotize them with the rapture in her voice. Her musical legacy is sealed forever in these television clips, as well as in her records. And her personal legacy is in her family. Husband Charlie Dick, her children Julie and Randy, and an extended family that is now four generations deep. In years to come, there will be hundreds who will be proud to call Patsy Cline their ancestor. The rest of us will simply be eternal fans.
Of love.